Tendrodox. So this is our second video in this yoga flexibility or yoga for inflexible people. So the next thing we want to do is we want to come onto all fours. So we're going to come into Chakravarttanasana. So shoulders are over our wrists and we have our hips over our knees. If this bothers your wrist, that crease there, you can always come on up onto fists for wrists, just like that, okay? So just work with what works for you. I'm comfortable right here. Then we want to check to make sure that we're not collapsing between our shoulder blades. Keep lifting tall, tall, tall. Use your abdominals to come on out of that. We're going to inhale, lift the head and arch the back. And exhale, round the spine and come on up. So it's inhale, little arch in the back, and then exhale. And you can wiggle through here if you want to turn your head in different directions. If you want to kind of shimmy the hips a little side to side, that's all available to you. You're just listening to your body and doing what feels good to you. Sometimes it feels good to hold this one for a little while, really get that nice stretch, and then bring it on down. So you're gonna play. If this bothers your knees at all, you can always pad them. Just put a little blanket or something underneath your knees. A lot of people like to do that. Forgot to say that, but that's always an option as well. And then from here, we're going to sit into our right hip. So you kind of lean into your hip, and you're going to bring it around. So your hands and knees. I like to widen my hands a little bit here and widen my knees when I do that. It gives me a bigger base. Sometimes my right knee cracks. In a good way, it feels good. And then go the other way. So we reverse. Keep it going. And take it back to center. Then I realign. So I put the knees back under the hips and I put the hands back underneath the shoulders for the next part. So the next part, we're going to kind of shimmy our hips. If you have, if you think about a dog wagging its tail, you kind of wag your butt. I know a dog, well, some dogs get really excited in their tail and their butts do wag, but we shimmy. Now keep that shimmying, but then you're going to add the rib cage to that. So the rib cage goes in one direction, the hips go another. And then add your shoulders to that. So now you have an S pattern going on with the spine. And I start to bend my elbows and get my shoulders involved too. So you get just a lot of movement. Then lastly, add your head. It may look weird, but it feels really good. It's just up, down, forward, sideways, backwards, whatever feels good. It's a great thing to do first thing in the morning when you're ultra stiff. It just feels nice. Once we've kind of played with that, we're going to sit back to child's pose. So we bring our hips down towards our heels, slide your hands forward, lower your head, and just sort of go. You can bring your hands behind you if you'd like. Maybe your forehead touches the floor. And we're going to slide our hands forward. Curl the toes under, lift your bottom and set them back down. So we have nice curled under toes here. Send your arms as long, as far as they'll go, and slightly wider than your shoulders, not a lot. We're gonna tent the fingers and try to keep your thumb and pointer finger close to each other. So we're tenting and then we're gonna slide our hands down. We've got the palm of our hand lifted with that Padabandha. And then you try to wiggle your hands back and forth and they shouldn't go anywhere. So if you're loose about this, you just slap your hand on the floor, your hand's gonna move, okay? And you've got no stability in your wrist whatsoever. So do a gripping motion, every single knuckle in the fingers, along with where your fingers meet your hand. That's all gripping right there. Hug your elbows towards each other, and then we're gonna float the knees off the ground. So even though it's yoga for inflexible people, you still need to have strength and flexibility. We're gonna start to straighten those legs into our downward facing dog. So we're gonna walk the dog. Bend one heel, or bend one knee, other heel down. Walk it out. And then kind of up and down, crack. All right. And then we'll just circle, little tiny circles. And reverse. Those hands should still be stable. We shouldn't be rolling to the pinky side. Every single knuckle should still be gripping. There's a little bit of a learning curve at first, but once you get used to this hand position, it makes downward dog so much easier, and it takes it out of the wrists. It's supposed to be mainly in the legs anyway, but then the other thing we want to think about is we bring our head between our hands. We're going to put our shoulder blades on our backs where they belong, so we're not out of our sockets. We're going to put them on our backs. Then find your downward dog. And we should have a much more stable. And also, if you ever have a mat and go, oh, it's a cheap mat that I bought and my hands are kind of moving all around, not if you practice your hand position this way, you can do downward dog on any surface. Okay, maybe not a greased surface or ice, but any surface other than that. So we're here. We're gonna send our right leg up behind. Bring our knee into our chest with a little hover. Come up onto the toes on the left leg, so that foot. Press it back. We're taking it to the side. We're going to take the outside arm, like Spider-Man climbing the wall, and press it back. And then cross it over, and press it back. And then open up the hip. And then bring it up, and other side. So we're going to send left leg into the air. It disappears, but it's there. I believe it. Bring it in, hover. You're on the end of that toe right there. Press it back. Take it out to the side. Press it back. Cross it over. Press it back. And then open up, let the foot fall. See right there, let it fall. And then take it back down, our downward dog. From here, we're gonna walk ourselves forward about halfway. And we'll bring our feet closer, our hands closer to our feet. A lot of people in forward fold tend to sit back here. They hang out in their joints. Their toes are lifted. Their hips are behind their heels. It's not where we want to be. Make sure your toes press down. Your weight is forward into those feet, into those toes. Fingers might be helping. And your hips should align right over your ankles. And we bend the knees. We're going to let our chest rest on our thighs. So rest. Shake out those wrists. And hold here. You can shake out the head, yes and no. You can bring the arms behind. Clasp and get a little bit more stretching through there. And bring it in. And then keeping our chest on our thighs, so there's that connection, they're touching each other. We're going to go ahead and try to straighten our legs. Mine don't straighten all the way. I'm really feeling my hamstrings here. So don't make the mistake of going, oh, I want straight legs, and throwing yourself into the next room. Keep that. Just get comfortable with that. My chest is touching my thighs. How straight can I straighten my legs? That's it. That's it. That's going to seduce them to cut open more than jamming your legs straight, hanging back here, and not even letting your muscles do any work. You're just in your joints here.
Okay.
So we just practice that. You can hang. You can kind of sway side to side if you wanted to. And hopefully the next video will play because this is where we're going to end this one. I'll see you in a bit.